our economies are well nosediving, are all nosediving towards recession. Greece has been there already in the last decade, a couple of times, unfortunately. I will argue that this time it really is different on many levels, especially for Greece. As I said earlier, there is no moral hazard considerations in COVID-19, no structural weaknesses to blame. Actually, Greece has relatively overperformed in the health crisis response, and I want to congratulate Greece on this. But what I want to highlight is the following. The country that has regained control of its economy 2 years ago and stands tall in the capital markets today in the face of a deep economic crisis is not the same country that requested financial assistance nearly a decade ago. Despite all the remaining challenges, Greece entered this health crisis with a stable economy, no macroeconomic imbalances, and with business activity in upswing. The pandemic shock may hold Greece back, but it won't knock it down. European solidarity is on its way and can help Greece return to its path of reform and consolidation. We have fought hard in the last couple of months to set up safety nets to shield the most affected nations and vulnerable sectors to protect the single market. There will be many funds available also in Greece. We have to make these funds count through productive investments. There is no troika here, but this is not a free-for-all. This is a golden opportunity, but only if we use these funds strategically and with a purpose for Europe. That is why positive rules on spending are needed. That is the best treatment we can prescribe. This is the same thing as a vaccine for our health system, but we really need to remain focused on European integration and, above all, coordination.
It will give real support to countries such as Greece to modernize its economy, raise productivity, and carry out vital reforms like improving the business environment and strengthening the financial system. Our recovery plan will also support investments in the future. For example, in a previous trip to Greece, I saw a flourishing startup community, tech companies offering solutions for SMEs, for tourism, for other sectors. Greece is also home to world-class research and innovation. However, to make sure that talent stays in a country and Greek researchers are not tempted to take their skills somewhere else, you need investment. And that's where our recovery plan could really help. For Greece, it means also extra support for its post-program commitments. Next Generation EU, when combined with the next EU multi-annual budget, will increase the total financing financial firepower to 1.85 trillion euros. At such time of extraordinary hardship and uncertainty, the EU needs to show that it's ready and willing to act decisively.
In the fourth phase, that of the reformation of the economy, the goal is to regain the dynamics it had developed before the health crisis. The more the economy stabilizes and restores, the more opportunities we will have to launch policies with more permanent characteristics so that the country can continue from where it was before the pandemic. We will take advantage of the conclusions from the recovery fund, investment in the fields of green economy, digital transformation, extroversion, research and development, which are included in our strategic plan for economic development. In conclusion, the government has designed and is implementing policies to stabilize and restructure the economy following the sudden shock of the pandemic. It builds on the enhanced reliability inside and outside Greece. It invests in the relationship of trust it has built with citizens. It works with a sense of solidarity, distributing the burden of the crisis fairly, taking on itself the greatest part of it. it creates the conditions for confirming the predictions for a strong recovery next year, so that as soon as possible to restart the recovery from the point where we left it before the health crisis. Thank you.
It is not just the unprecedented magnitude of this support mechanism that makes us optimistic, but also their scope and determination. The Greek economy has experienced substantial outright disinvestment since the onset of the financial crisis over one decade ago, critically reducing the capital stock. The EU Recovery Fund is critical in filling the investment gap so that Greece can return to truly sustainable growth. The importance of the EU Recovery Fund for the future of the Greek economy cannot be overstated. Equally, we are aware of the key role that banks like us have to play to complement the effort, financing investment and the recovery, attracting private sector resources. It is my deepest conviction that is the first time since 2007 that Greece stands a very good chance for a sustained and above-trend period of economic expansion.